Today I'm going to be putting the water pump kit on a 2008 Yamaha 4-stroke 115 horses. Alright everybody, let's start by disconnecting the water hose at the back. There you go. Alright buddy, you got to remove your trim tab, which is underneath here, to access the bottom bolt, which is covered by the trim tab. So you gotta remove this little cover. This guy in here is a 12 millimeter. These are all 14, this one's 12. Don't forget to catch it at the bottom. This trim tab. And there's the bolt underneath you gotta get to. The ones on the side. I'm gonna leave one so it doesn't drop on me and fall on my foot or it gets damaged. So I'm gonna remove them all. I'm just gonna leave one. Make sure it's a nail drill. Forgot to mention that, guys. All right, I'm gonna start easing off the bolt I left on the other side, catching it at the same time. There it is. All right, folks, so back in the shed. I made this from some leftover wood from some of my projects. Came out pretty good. Keeping it in place so it doesn't hurt me or hurt itself. This is the kit. It came with all the parts that you need to get the job done. So stick them all out of the plastics and make sure we get them all aligned and ready. So much plastic ended up with just a few parts. These are 12 millimeters. steel was busted. Make sure to inspect this, see any cracks or anything. Clean it up very well. Remove the cover and retainer gently so that you don't crack anything. I didn't see this one in the kit, so looks like we're gonna be reusing it. There it goes. Plastic retainer. And then we should have two washers with a spring washer in the middle. Washer, spring washer. Let's see if I can get the second one. You have, folks, you have a washer, spring washer, and another washer. It's like a collapsible washer that retains a force. Remove the impeller. The impeller looked like it was in good shape, but since I wasn't the one to service this engine last, I don't know what they did, so I'm not taking a chance, especially with the water pump. Now I'm removing the plate at the bottom. Got the washer. Good thing I put that rack there because it was gonna fall in. Rusted. Rusted up pretty bad. Always lubricate these, it doesn't happen. And the guides are rusted too. So we're gonna pull those out. It's a good time to clean up and inspect everything. Goes the gasket, and we gotta pull these now. Do it gently so you don't damage the housing. Twist them and pop them out. There we go, so silly. Perfect, there you go. I don't know what happened there, I got lost. All right, let's get those guides in. Remember to use a small hammer so that you don't damage anything. I like to put a little bit of anti-seize. Works better than any oil or grease. These rust up very easily. Careful you don't drop it too. next is the plate. Make sure this this part goes to the bottom so it doesn't shave your impeller. This is rough, smooth. So this is the top. Don't forget, guys, the small nipple goes to the front, bigger one goes to the back. So it should be perfect right there. Wipe off any excess, any seeds you don't need. Up next, let's get this guy in. That's how it goes. Lubricated good, you're gonna need it. If you look at it, it's got to stop here and just open so it slides in. This is the bottom part. So far, so good. I'm gonna get that housing in now. On the housing, lube it up really good. Put some grease so that this guy will slide in. And remember, you gotta turn it clockwise, like this. looks like all the splines are in good. Alright, so I went ahead and got all the parts cleaned up. And everything good, ready to go. So, just gotta put in these two guys. Washer, washer, then the collapse washer in the middle. It goes in like this. Washer, collapse, washer. Plastic one, and this guy looks like he's gonna give me some trouble getting it in there, but we'll see how it goes. Here comes the metal one. I'm gonna lube it up really good so it slides in. Let's see if I can do it gently. Not all the way in yet. All right, guys. So take your time aligning it. Those two little pins, these guys right here, they go in like that, about right there. But to get them aligned, was a little bit of a headache, but I managed to get them aligned. Hopefully everything looks good. And I looped everything up and I'm just gonna tighten it up. All right, and that's it for today. I'm gonna reinstall it tomorrow. All right, folks, let's finish the job. Make sure you guys have a bolt at hand so that you can secure it. And make sure you align everything properly without damaging anything else. The steering shaft needs to be aligned properly in order for it to go in right. If not, it won't. Other than that, everything else seems to have gone in there okay. And the hose was giving me a little bit of trouble too. It's a little heavy, but it can be done with one person.